So TCP has all of these provisions to deal with packet loss and other failures. But why do these ever happen in the first place? Why don't networks just be super reliable so nothing ever gets dropped? Well, that's not always an option. Imagine that you have two machines, A and B, attached to two different fast networks. But those fast networks are connected by a slow network in the middle. Like, maybe these are two offices with gigabit Ethernet, and the connection between them is only 10 megabit. That's 100 times slower. Then host A tries to send a big pile of data over to host B. Let's say, a gigabyte of data. Because its own network interface is very fast, in theory, host A could transmit this data as far as its nearby router in about 8 seconds. But that data also has to travel over this slow link. And because that's 100 times slower, over that 10 megabit network, that's going to take 13 minutes. Where does that data have to live in the meantime? If host A were allowed to just push that big pile of data onto the network, in order for it to get through, this router would have to buffer it in memory and trickle it out over this slow link over the next 13 minutes. And meanwhile, nobody else on this network would be able to send anything. This link would be saturated, completely full. That wouldn't be a very good outcome, so TCP and routers don't actually do it that way. Instead, TCP doesn't start sending data at full blast. It starts out slowly, only increasing speed when the other end shows it can keep up by sending acknowledgments back. If packets are dropped, it slows down, and then gradually it speeds up again. And routers work with this by dropping packets if the link they're trying to send on is too busy. The result of this is that the endpoints and the routers in the middle collaborate to move data at close to an optimal speed. But this only works because routers are willing to drop packets in order to signal congestion, and endpoints are willing to slow down in response. If the router just let everything queue up, the whole connection would eventually time out. This is called TCP congestion control, and it's one of the most important performance features of TCP.